What is up, guys? Back with another 150 kid underscore VR video. Yeah, we're playing 2K again. Yep, 2K, back with 2K. Yep. Let's do a random team selector. A team USA. Team USA against Team USA. Okay. This will be crazy. Alright, here we go, guys.
Thank you for tuning into this Sunday afternoon.
This is weird. I mean, I picked Team USA, Team USA.
Alongside Greg Anthony and Steve Smith, with David Aldridge on the sideline, this is Kevin Harlan. It's USA and USA. Looking at the starting five for USA. They've got Chris Paul. LeBron James is out there with Durant. And it's Chandler. And it's Kobe in at the two. Al Paul. After the missed three from KD. Paul with the bucket.
I think the pull-up jump shot is one of the most dangerous shots.
All right, here we go. Here we go.
He is so quick on that shot.
James kicks to Chandler. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. That's on LeBron.
Here. Let's quit this. Hawks. Magic. I'm gonna head uniform. Alright, here we go. That happens every time.
It's a beautiful Sunday afternoon. Welcome to the NBA. And these are two high-flying teams, Grant. Loads of athleticism on the floor. What's it like to play in a game like this?
Oh, BA, it is the best. It's so much fun. I mean, of course, here we're expecting lots of fast breaks, dunks, just in general, a lot of action. And of course, the fans love these type of games. I can't wait.
A look at the opening lineup for the Orlando Magic. Suggs is out there with Wagner. Then it's Wendell Carter. Then there's Banchero. And it's Bol in at the four slot. And Young gets it to go.
The perimeter.
All right, here we go. We're starting this game off with a three. A three.
Shots from range.
Pass to Ben Carroll. Five on the clock. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two.
Offensively, Banchero is a difference maker, not just with the talent, but with his relentless approach.
Grant, you watch Banchero. He's got a rare mix of moves.
Atlanta Hawks won 2015 final.
Strength and skill. Crosses up defenders well, spin moves, excellent body control, and he uses his body to shield the ball when he's driving through the lane.
Now here's Young.
Ball
grabs the board.
Hey, I'm gonna check something real quick. So I'm gonna check my phone. Alright.
Here's Suggs. Guarded by Young. Here's Carter. And slammed in by Carter.
Jalen Suggs has proven early, if you're open, he's going to find you. Pretty pass.
Outside Young. Let's go with a three, bearing his second of three attempts.
I love this approach. Getting him involved early, and it's already paying off.
They know that if this guy goes off, their chances of winning rise exponentially.
Yep, that one goes.
How about the agility of Jalen Suggs to navigate the painted area and finish? Pretty nice stuff right there.
And that streaking rack attack is the mobile one drive.
Yeah, and in close games like this one, BA, you need toughness. Guys who
here we go.
Fight.
That's another three. That's another three-pointer.
The Magic have gone 3 of 3 so far from the floor. Here's Suggs. Carter from outside. Atlanta with a rebound. Murray passes to Capella. The three is up. And the Hawks with another three.
Another three-pointer.
Stay connected to him on the perimeter.
Here's Suggs, guarded by Young.
Oh.
Takes a step back, puts it up from 12, and another basket for Orlando.
Jalen Suggs has all the attributes necessary to be a three-level scorer. That means the mid-range must be pure. Show him, Jalen.
There's Young with the three. Gets the three to four.
Wow. Young's hitting threes like crazy, guys.
And I think the defender knows once he gets cooking, look out. The bucket looks awfully big to him right now.
And Carroll, no good. The Hawks have gone 5 of 6. They're rolling.
Well, after the first round exit in 22, the Hawks front brass admitted perhaps they've been too complacent with the roster. So that changed this summer, trading for an all-star in DeJounte Murray. He can make a big impact with his two-way talent.
Here's Suggs, guarded by Young. From 9 feet out, Hunter with some nice D. The Hawks leading. From deep, Capella, and the Hawks with another three.
Their ability to space the floor has been the story
this
of this game.
Crazy.
And what surprises me is the defense hasn't done anything to take away that three-point shot. That has been their preferred weapon tonight. Well, that's a blown defensive coverage, but it doesn't matter. He cannot answer the bell.
Fires it, and again, it's Atlanta.
And early on, they've been on a tear, just getting whatever they want offensively.
Well, what I love is the game plan is pretty solid from the opening tip. And guys are making their shots.
I guess that's maybe the feeling day.
Now a timeout called by Orlando.
All right, time to put in the best players that we have.
Getting ready for the Hawks. Okongwu's checked in for Clint Capella. Johnson comes in for Collins. Griffin, he's checked in for Hunter. And Bogdanović is subbed in for DeJounte Murray.
It's only the first quarter.
Here's Ross.
I mean, I'm not really trying.
Shoots over Young. Ross can't get it to go. Bogdanović from long range. 2 points. That one goes.
They've been very effective so far. A balanced attack at its best.
On the offensive end, it feels like they're getting the shots they want. And defensively, they are connected and on a string.
And once again, off the mark by Orlando. And a chance to add to the lead here.
Yeah, B.A., they should really stick with what they've been doing.
And the three-pointer goes.
Let's go. Let's do it. We're making three-pointers like crazy. And I'm like, oh, I'm gonna guard you. Let's do it.
Here's Ross. Shoots over Okongwu. No good off the back of the rim. Boy, what a run. The points just piling up, Grant.
Hey, whatever they discovered here, it's working for them. And just totally relentless, only increasing the intensity level.
One thing I enjoy is watching players who don't pay attention to the score. You lock in on the moment and play the right way.
Now here's Anthony. Well, he hasn't put up any points yet in this one. Takes it inside, and they pick up two.
This guy is so creative.
All right, we're going to have to need about 4 3-pointers in this much seconds.
Cole Anthony.
Young from long range, and the Hawks with another three.
He's a potent mix of effort and ability. Hard to shut down a player of his caliber.
Trying to find a spark here.
Yes, indeed. A rough stretch off.
I think about that. The foul. It's like, if you want to get points, you kind of have to foul.
Five seconds left in the first quarter here. Pulls up on the wing. Boy, clanks that one off the back iron and it falls.
Well, terrific to see Markel Fultz knock it down, looking more and more assertive in the mid-range.
And the Hawks tack on two more.
What a great shooting performance. His percentage is outstanding.
Anthony against Bogdanovich. Launches it. Rebound Atlanta. Takes the three. And the Hawks with another three.
And taking a look at this first half, they've just shown better shot selection.
And I think, obviously, we see the execution and the willingness to make the next pass so important.
And so it's Atlanta, a huge 20.
What's it? I haven't paid attention to this score. Holy crap.
It's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in the second. And a moment now to quickly take a look at the offensive approach for the Hawks.
Yeah, their early focus on outside scoring has paid off. They're finding plenty of points from three-point land.
And their assist total.
I'm too good.
Early, creating with the pass and playing for teammates.
Setting the floor for the Magic. We've got Banchero. Markel Fultz is out there with Wagner. Then it's Wendell Carter. And it's Bol in at the power forward position. Wagner outside. Just five on the clock. Shoots from the right block.
A quality defender. Capella uses his size and reach to erase shots.
This is my first, this is my second 2K video. Come if you want more 2K.
And here are the Magic now. And then Carroll gets it to go.
Assistant Wendell Carter Jr.
One side is dominated tonight.
Yeah, they've done a fantastic job of imposing their pace and style of play.
Nails it from beyond the arc.
Watch how Young outsmarts the defense, going for the pull-up jumper when they're unprepared. And this summer, the Magic raised some eyebrows, widely expected to take Jabari Smith with the number one overall pick. Right up until their selection, Paolo Banchero was announced. Rival teams impressed at how well they kept their secret. Good job, Orlando.
From deep, sinks it. What range from downtown. Young's got 28 points for the game. Wagner with a screen. Here's Fultz. And a strong finish with two hands.
Well, this has to contribute to Markel Fultz's confidence, showing right there he can get through the defense.
Gives us a chance to catch up with Allie LaForce.
My phone's been going off like crazy.
Magic head coach Jamal Mosley continues to lay the foundation for the team they want to be. A, quote, tough-talking, tied-together defensive team that plays offensively with pace, space, and the pass. Brian, say that five times fast.
Well done, Allie. Thank you. It'll be fun to watch him build. Here's Carter. Takes the assist and lays it in. Nice setup. Carter's got six.
Wendell Carter Jr., it matters not where he is on the floor, right? This guy's touch is excellent. Sometimes a nice inside shot. Yeah, give me an easy two.
The three-point shot has been his weapon of choice this quarter.
Fultz against Young. Pass to Banchero. With the crossover. The rebound by Murray. Here's Atlanta with the ball. They're on a 15-6 run. Young from long range. Another three for Atlanta.
Trust Young to put the offense on his back. He loves showing up and doing big numbers for his team.
Here's Fultz. Off the mark with the outside fadeaway. The Hawks have gotten each of their six shots to fall here in the second. His first shot coming late. And it's Atlanta scoring again.
What an incredible ankle breaker to help create space for his shot.
Pass to Banchero. The shot is good. Fultz making the play. Banchero's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Well, this guy knows it's his role to get his guys going. Fultz doing a nice job moving the ball. Boy, he's been unconscious this quarter. I love the
too many threes.
He's playing with.
You know, some have said those old-school power forwards, guys like Charles Oakley, they're becoming outdated. You see that, Grant?
Well, first of all, the physicality in the game is no more. The way Oakley would hit you and bruise you, you can't do that in today's game. And guys like Oakley are now playing the five position, and they're shooting three-pointers. So a lot of it just is because the game has changed and evolved. since the 90s when Oakley dominated.
A great skill level in the game right now.
No question.
Connects again from distance.
He's been on the money from deep.
Definitely. Looking to shoot as much as possible. Young against Fultz. Pass to Bancaro. Hunter with a double. Outside Carter. Rebound Atlanta.
Boy, he'll usually knock it down if he's left that wide open. Just comes up empty.
Ooh, took him no time at all to get that one. Young's got 45 points.
A jumper that is pretty and effective. Young's game starts with his shot.
From short range, Fultz can't get it to go. Atlanta with the ball. And when John Collins takes off from the floor, you can feel your hair start to stand up.
One of the most explosive players in the league with this incredible liftoff.
Man, we're getting him in such really good range. It's crazy.
An electric player at times.
Fultz against Young. Pass to Bancaro. Inside, Carter, and it's slammed in by Carter.
Boy, you see Carter Jr. use every bit of that 7'5" wingspan. Boy, he is tough to guard around the rim. Look out.
Out of bounds. It'll be Orlando's ball.
Okay. I shot it too far.
Be on him about that one.
And the Hawks will go for a different look here. Okongwu's checked in for Clint Capella. Johnson comes in.
Like,
for
I'm
Collins.
Trying to best get the 80
Griffin,
points before the half
he's
is
checked
over.
In for Hunter. And Bogdanović is subbed in for DeJounte Murray. Now a timeout called by Atlanta.
Here we go.
For Orlando, they've gotten 6 shots to fall out of 13 attempts here in the second.
Defense. Defense.
Let's it go from
defense.
11. Suggs, no good.
All right, let's go. We gotta go.
There's Young with the 3, and again for 3. Ooh, you can tell he's feeling it right now.
The BA, he's on fire.
And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Trae Young. That's foul number 2 for him. There's 31 seconds left in the first half of this one. Wagner on the wing. Over Young. And the Magic again can't hit. And here's a Okongwu for 3. And the Hawks with another 3.
Ooh. All right, 15 seconds to actually.
Pass to Ross.
Shoot it and make it.
Rebounded by the Hawks. Here's a Okongwu.
Oh, I didn't make it.
Providing a lot of energy for the Atlanta Hawks. He added to his astounding total of 3-pointers in this quarter. He may never have another night like this. All right, Allie's ready to go. She's courtside. Hey, Allie.
Thanks, guys.
All right, Allie, thanks for that. We will see everyone right back after this break. Ready for the second.
Oh, I didn't get the 81 points. You got really close, though, and that's good.
And after a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly in the second. We're seeing a tremendous game from Trae Young.
Through the first 2 quarters, he's been on fire. Explosive offensive performance.
Boy, he has been shouldering the load. Aggressive, skilled.
All right, let's try. We might not make it to 100 points this game, which kind of sucks, but it's fine.
At the 4. Young runs point with Murray at the 2. And it's Capella in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. So that's the lineup for Atlanta. It's Suggs with a drive and a missed layup. Atlanta with the ball. And the Hawks going from the Eastern Conference Finals to the eighth seed via play-in. A bit of a step backwards last year.
Yeah. You know, growing as a young team has its ups and downs. Hawks know they can be better than the eighth seed. They now have an expectation of a playoff caliber ball club. Man, that's his shot. Maybe he was too wide open.
Oh, wasted no time on that one. Hunter's got his second bucket of the game.
And since the halftime break, their offense has just been on another level.
I gotta believe that's something the coach talked to them about at the halftime. They have valued each possession.
Second half of basketball, just over a minute played so far. And there it is for him.
That's about simply playing hard. Wagner doing what it takes to find a shot in the interior.
Murray for three. And the Hawks with another three.
Everything is dropping for them. Just a terrific third period run.
And I think it's been all about their offense.
And we got two quarters.
Shooting the lights out in this quarter.
From downtown, Suggs, no good.
I think he's gone completely dry. Nothing is hitting.
And this is where you hope that he can find something easy so he can see the ball go through the net.
They are unconscious from outside. And so far, the defense has had no answer.
All right, we're at 90 points. At least he has to at least get 112.
Well, at least, because for the defense to account for everyone.
Here's Ben Carroll. Collins defending. Shot clock at six. Down low. Oh, sent away with authority.
You can't sleep on Collins' long arms when he's defending you. He'll swat you down all day with that long reach. And they're refusing to take a break, even with a nice lead. They just continue to attack. You have to love it.
And that, to me, is a sign of excellent coaching. There's an attention to detail. There is valuing of every possession.
Bogdanovich has checked in for Atlanta. Here's Harris. Lays it up and banks it in.
Well, Gary Harris is getting points inside. Defense could be in for a long night, folks.
And we just had to see that mobile one drive one more time. Great stuff.
Yeah, a double-digit deficit. They're going to have to play better. They need more of this kind of aggressive play. And the DeJounte Murray trade sort of came out of left field. Seemed mutual as the Spurs went to a younger direction and wanted Murray to play for a contender. A trade where everyone involved gets what they want. Their offense is looking like a well-oiled machine, getting any look they want.
Well, what great game planning, what great execution. It doesn't get much better than this.
Harris against Bogdanovich. Over to the wing, Okiki. The three-pointer off the mark.
And you can tell right there, the defense is totally fine with him shooting that. That's not his game.
And here's Collins for three. Another three for Atlanta.
And sometimes Collins makes
banks it down to 100.
As if the three shot is just that easy.
A little under 3.5 minutes off the clock now in the third quarter. Pass to Suggs. Will it go? They get the rebound.
Got it.
Collins with the big block. From deep 3-point range. It's rebounded by Wagner.
That's too deep.
We all know he's a good shooter. But from that distance, I don't think so.
Boy, we're seeing it.
I made a half court shot and half court shot. Here, next time I get the ball, I'm gonna go for a half court shot.
Pass to Suggs. Carter, a screen on Hunter. Back to Carter. Shoots from 12. So it'll be two free throws. He was fouled in the act.
All right, two free throws coming.
That one over Pella.
Listen, it is not easy to guard a big, physical, tough guy like Wendell Carter Jr., right? Without fouling him, it's not easy to do.
Happy New Year's. I forgot this. Or, you got the big one. They're both loud. That one's a little softer, and this one.
The doors for the Magic, like they are still developing.
Yes, B.A., there's no doubt they're still developing. Lots of youth on this roster. It's an organization that has not made it out of the first round of the playoffs since
back in the 09-10 season.
So much growth is needed, but you hope is the losing hasn't taken a toll on the culture.
And so Carter nails them both. Well, I know you spent a lot of your career in Orlando. What are your favorite memories of that time?
None, B.A.
I have court shot.
You know, I was hurt the entire time while I was in Orlando. No, but in all seriousness, they were great people, great city, and it was fun to see young guys like Jameer Nelson and Dwight Howard get drafted and emerge as great players and leaders for their ball club.
Orlando has got nothing to fall here in the third. 0-4. Anthony, the pass to Ross.
For now on, I'm going to take half-court shots. I'm only going to let them score. I mean, they won't catch up.
Of where the
but.
Open man was going to be, and Terrence Ross finds him immediately. That's really pretty.
Yeah.
Give him 8.
I don't know what he was thinking. Maybe settling a score with his coach?
Well, that is inexcusable. That kind of shot selection won't do them any good.
Here's Harris. Oh, nice finish from the low block. That one's good. 1 minute left in the third quarter. Murray, no good. The Magic shooting just about 33% since this second half started. Here's Ross, and he takes the feed in stride and slams it home.
You love it when a point guard is eager to reward open men, and Cole Anthony delivering the ball on time and on target.
Oh, got that one up quick. Murray's got 9 points here in the second half.
All right.
Even though he hasn't lit up the
9 points.
I like how he's keeping others
in the
involved.
Second half.
Bogdanovich against Ross. Pass to Anthony. Let's the three fly. Rebounded by Johnson. So it's Atlanta now. From deep. The shot off that time. Well, Orlando's shooting just 38%. Their offense not.
This is like a wild game.
Right side Ross.
We need to have two teams.
Johnson's got his fourth rebound in this one. He gets it up. It's good. It's good at the buzzer. Wow.
What a huge shot to beat the buzzer. My goodness.
Well, that's the perfect end of the quarter for them. You have no idea how much of an effect those buzzer beaters can have on a team's momentum.
At the end of the third quarter, a huge lead. This one may have already been decided. The Hawks on top, running away with this one. Don't go anywhere. The final quarter is
this is crazy.
And let's take this
like,
opportunity to show
low
you
key crazy. I know in my last video I beat the team like a lot.
This was a choice
but
because I
this
love
is low key crazy. And I stayed up all night filming that video. It took me 34 minutes to film. It took me a little longer than normal. Let's see where we're at. Yeah, we're at like 27 minutes? Really? 27 minutes. That's crazy. But I didn't really know that.
And there have been two very different performances from these teams today. As we
Let's
get going,
finish
in
this
quarter
game
number four. On the court for the Magic, Mo Bamba out there with Mo Wagner. Then it's R.J. Hampton. Then it's Gary Harris. And it's Okiki in at the three. The
oh, Kaka.
From deep, Johnson. He buries it for three. All right, well, a look at how the hustle game has been going for the Hawks.
Well, you have to like what you've seen from them defensively. They've done well contesting shots and have managed to come away with some blocks, too.
And another theme in this game to me, guys, has been how lethal they've been in transition. Attack on the break and make sure you convert.
A clear look for Bamba. Forrest with a rebound.
I need to start posting Gorilla Tiger
Here's
videos.
Here's Atlanta with the ball. From deep three-point range. It's rebounded by Wagner.
What was he thinking? That's not within his range at all.
I'm a little surprised he would even attempt that shot. Much better to swing the ball to somebody else.
Atlanta's gone 1 of 2 from deep in this quarter. Holiday from long range knocks down the long J. Holiday's gotten himself on the board with a three there.
Woo! That man is laser focused. Now, that's bad defense for a team that has a long way to go to catch up.
Well, credit the offense, though. If you're going to come with casual defensive effort, this team's responsibility is to take advantage, and they do.
Hey, expanding his range. Another three for Atlanta.
Coming down the stretch.
I'm just doing threes.
The three-point arc has been a major factor in what they've done here tonight. You love
Shut
the
up,
aggressiveness.
Let me quank.
Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So two free throws for him coming up.
You know, this Hawks team really does score the ball well. Lots of dynamic players on this team. And Young has made a huge difference in their production.
And the first one at the line is good. So about Atlanta, just how far can this team make it?
Well, B.A., there's no question they'll be efficient on the offensive end. But the question is, can they put everything else together and be a complete team? That'll ultimately be the difference.
Fultz, he's checked in for Bamba.
Doesn't need a lot of room to get off his shot. That was funny. Right.
Fultz against Holiday. Fultz is good.
Well, make no mistake, Markelle Fultz, because of his athletic burst, can score on the interior. That's nicely done.
Here's Forrest.
Hampton. Too far.
Board. The Magic have gotten only 1 of 5 to fall here in the fourth. Fultz passes to Wagner, and it's flushed down. A nice jam.
Well, that possession to me highlights the importance of creating for your teammates.
Three-pointer, Holiday. Nails it from three. Holiday's got 9 points now in the second half.
During this final quarter, he's erupted from outside the arc.
I didn't know we were gonna make it. Like,
now is going in.
Pass to Okiki. Puts up a three. Tries again. Fultz. Rebound Atlanta. Johnson's got 6 rebounds here tonight. And here's Okongwu for three. That one falls. Nice feed that time from Holiday. Okongwu's got 6 points in the quarter.
Coach is loving the ball movement.
Here's Okiki. All sorts of time. Rebound Atlanta. Okongwu's got 6 rebounds in the game. Pass to Forrest. Outside Holiday to the paint. Here's Okongwu. Hey, he's now 6 for 6. He is cooking right now.
And trust me, when the D's slow to react, he'll be the first guy to make them pay.
And that's typical of this guy. He's always reading the situation, reacting quickly, and capitalizing.
There's a screen by Okiki. For three, here's Harris. They get it back. Wagner. And there's the bucket. Staying with it that time. Offensive glass getting it done.
That, to me, is exactly the kind of play you want from Mo Wagner. Aggressively chasing the rebound.
Wow, we're just hitting threes.
And they keep feeding him.
Like, this is crazy. But
Fultz passes to
Wagner. I'm gonna film a Gorilla Tech video and stream tonight, or stream later, after the video. By the time you're watching this, it's probably live right now.
Awareness. Passes like that will create all kinds of chemistry.
And the basket by Holiday.
He's hitting everything from deep, just flat out torching this defense.
Fultz with it, guarded now by Holiday. That one rolls around and rims out. Fultz has gotten 3 of his 8 shots to go. And here's Okongwu for three. And the Hawks with another three.
Absolutely ruthless. He's not about to start showing mercy now.
Well, when it's closing time, he's trying to lock the door. He's been going all night.
And what a complete performance we saw from them. A dominant win in every way for the Hawks.
And it was a big-time performance across the board. They looked like they were having fun out there, Grant.
Yeah, B.A., it was almost like watching a cat play with a mouse. I mean, they did pretty much anything they wanted to do out there today.
And as it was happening, as it was building,
this game really, like, just
turned
crazy.
What a relentless scoring night for this guy. In attack mode all evening.
Puts it up from 12. Wagner for three. Here's Fultz. Okongwu with the rebound.
Boy, that's one he wishes he could have back, especially against soft defense.
Gets the three ball to go.
Showing us that killer instinct right now. No letting the foot off the gas for them.
And you want to save your best for last. Tonight, they've done that and then some.
Wow.
Boy, guys, you look at the history of
39 seconds left in the fourth quarter. I am very surprised.
Driven by great players. Penny Hardaway and Shaquille O'Neal, of course, and Dwight Howard.
All right.
The first one falls.
Well, guys, certainly Markelle Fultz had a rocky start with his first organization, but the change of scenery has helped him immensely, and I think he's proven, while still finding
best
his footing, that there
just
is a place
scoring
for him at this level.
Bamba's checked in for Orlando. Ross comes in for Hampton.
They got a big lift from their crowd tonight, giving them the energy they needed.
What an impressive performance, to say the least. At this point, it looks insurmountable.
We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and game clock. Here's Atlanta with the ball. And here's Collins for three. And the Hawks with another three. 19 seconds left in the fourth quarter here. Here's Fultz. The shot, no good. Hunter with some nice D.
I'm going to hit the buzzer beater.
Collins outside. Shoots over Fultz. And it's good. So we see the Hawks taking the W here. Well, this might not have been the most competitive game we've ever seen, but you've got a
high-scoring game
performance.
And I'm sure their fans appreciated it, too. We saw the outstanding defense and a loaded offensive effort. They were just dominant out there.
All right, let's go courtside to Allie LaForce with our player of the game. Allie, it's all yours.
Trey, this is a young team. Talk about the chemistry and the connection and how you play together.
If you're around us outside of the locker room, you can tell why we support each other so well, and the energy we have for each other on the court. You can tell the reason why we do that. And I love this group.
The connection is there on and off the court. Guys?
All right, Allie, good stuff there. Thanks for that. Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Grant Hill, Allie LaForce, and Doris Burke, and the rest of our 2K team, this is Brian Anderson signing off as New Balance presents our player of the game, Trey Young.
I want to do this stuff. Holy crap, 50 point. Oh my god. Alright. Alright, good video. Yeah.